Hello, guten Abend. My name is Anton Gavrilov. I work in Parity. Just in case if you don't know what Parity is, we develop quite popular Ethereum client and some other Ethereum products. I want to talk a little bit, very briefly, about our latest additions into Parity, named Private Transactions. It will be very, very high level and quick presentations. I don't think that we will be able to start developing new product after presentation immediately. So, but maybe it will be a good start and you'll have some understanding what you can do and most importantly, what you cannot do with it and what is this for. So let me start from the context first, why it's all needed and why it's all, what's the reasoning for all of this? In spite of the rumors that Ethereum will recently replace all big corporations, banks, etc., and things that right now is been done with thousands of man force will be done in 10 lines of code. In spite of all of these rumors, still Ethereum not the perfect solution for enterprise use cases, as I call them. There are multiple reasons, of course. Here I list two of them because they are important from the standpoint of this presentation. First of all, it's permissioning. As you probably know, that in Ethereum, every node can do anything. And all permissioning that right now exists can be done, for example, on smart contracts level or somewhere else. And the second part that's also pretty important for this presentation is data privacy. You don't believe how many people believe or don't know that everything that they are doing in terms of their contracts are publicly available. So a lot of people think that is that's happening only on their nodes and all other people don't know what's going on. Still, as I've said here, all data is available for all nodes, surprisingly. There are several classical approaches what to do with it, how to nevertheless build this solution with enterprise features using Ethereum. The first classical approach is so-called private blockchain, private chain. That's pretty obvious, I think. The second approach, just to add more layers, more components into your solution. And if you are exchange, don't store anything on blockchain. I mean, don't store private data, don't store on crucial data, store it somewhere else, but operate on blockchain as needed. And the third approach, to modify protocol a little bit, or not a little bit. There are known solutions like Quorum, like Hyperledger, and they create product based on Ethereum, but with several additions that support these use cases. In Parity, we are trying to achieve it also, modifying and providing more functionality in our clients, Ethereum clients. Here, private transactions is only the part of them. Here I list three major companies, but there are more, of course. The first one is transactions permissioning. Using Parity, you can achieve permissioning and you can assign permission to nodes. So you can deploy your network and assign several nodes permission, like creating contracts, calling contracts, creating transactions, and so on and so forth. The second big part of our called permissioning features, but it's just some name for well, this part of work. The second part is secret store. It's a pretty interesting thing, and I encourage you to read about it more, because I'm not going to cover it in this presentation. Basically, secret store is aimed to create, generate, and save and manage secret keys that can be used for symmetric encryption. So basically, it's a parity node that is running in special mode. The third part here, the major part, is private transactions. Basically, the idea is to have encrypted smart contracts operated on private or public chain. Of course, I will talk about it more next. But as I said, everything is achieved through modification of parity clients. So we need to have parity clients deployed in your network. Here, very, very, very high level picture how it works. As I've said, we store smart contract in an encrypted way. In order to store it, we use a special wrapping public contract, and we store everything encrypted inside it as special fields. So, in order to view data inside this contract, a node that has access to a key has to decrypt it, and using special IP, of course, special API, has to decrypt it. In order to modify data inside this special private contract, it's more complicated story. Of course, you have to decrypt it first, make some changes in state of a contract, this private contract. After that, all these changes must be validated by special nodes. This provides guarantee that all these changes will be made on accepted state, based on accepted state, and all these changes are validated. After changes are validated, regular public transaction is created, but payload for it is also just encrypted data that is changing some encrypted fields inside this public contract. So for all users that don't have access to keys, is just public contract with encrypted fields inside. So we don't see what is it inside these fields. We don't see code of this smart contract, so we don't know what's going on. Here you can see that all keys are stored inside secret store, so you need to have it running for this solution. Of course, right now deployment procedure is quite complicated. It's, I don't know, not for beginners, let's say. The first version of this solution is in production in Coven. It's very important to know which limitation it has. Most important limitation concern this private contract. So I call it simplify contract, but basically we don't support events, we don't support logs yet, we don't support tracing yet, and in order to work with it, you need to work using parity.js library, not web3.js. So in web3.js, it's also not supported. As I said, it's deployed on Coven. We're fixing bugs, working on backlog. So all these limitations that already listed Variant Backlog, of course, for next version. But most importantly, what we are interested in right now is use cases. This work was done in terms of our energy web project. And of course, we had in mind some use cases, some scenario, how this functionality can be used. But still, we don't know actually how it will be used in reality. So because it's very new functionality, and we'd love to hear your use cases, how you want to use it, which functionality you want to have, which is crucial for you, which is more important for you. We Parity as a platform. We'd love to provide this functionality for you in short time if it's needed. But still, for us, it's very important to know it's first. Here, as I said, a couple of links, but they are pretty easily Googled. It's our wiki and our GitHub. So on the wiki, there are several tutorials how to start, how to deploy it, and of course very detailed description and more detailed description how it works, not just this very high level diagram. So it's a good place to start, and of course if you have any questions, ideas, requests, feel free to contact us. We love any feedback, and we're eager to talk to you about it, so feel free. That's basically it. I think I left some time for questions, but also very short ones, I believe, right? Okay, thank you.